Hi, my name is Mark Poulton. I'm a buy and hold real estate investor in the greater Charlotte, North Carolina area. I want to tell you, I want to give great advice from somebody who's been doing this for quite a while, and that's don't cheap out on fixtures like faucets, kitchen faucets, bathroom faucets, and even shower faucets, depending on how it works. I just got back from one of the rentals, and I had to replace the kitchen faucet. It really had a cheap faucet on, and it was a standard, no frills, but the faucet just failed. And it's not a cartridge faucet, at least that I can tell, and even if it was, it's not worth trying to save. But I replaced it with a Moen, single handle, pull out. It was $98 after tax at the Home Depot. Probably can get them cheaper. I've used products like Glacier Bay, and they do have a warranty on them. I've actually bought some used that have problems. I'll call them up and they'll send you it. But I've really found that Moen makes some of the best products out there as far as longevity and warranty. And their kitchen faucets since like 97 or something, it's something ridiculous. Use the same type of cartridge, so and it's got a lifetime warranty on it. So you just call them up, tell them the model number, where it's at. You know, bada bing, bada boom, 8 days later, you got a brand new cartridge that didn't cost you anything. And you can do the Home Depot switch out. You know, that may be a little ethically under the table, but you know, you can go buy the cartridge at Home Depot, replace it at your tenant's place, and then come back, and when you get the new one, just return it to Home Depot. Oftentimes, though, you can usually wait like 8 days. You know, this particular kitchen faucet also comes with the hoses. You know, they're pretty long, maybe a foot and a half, maybe 2 feet. And that saves, you know, another $7 or $8 of having to buy steel braided hoses and putting them in there. And it's just a much better, cleaner, tighter installation. But the thing that I've found over the year, I also had to replace the bathroom faucet. Bear in mind, both of these probably came with the house when I bought it. We weren't flush with cash. We weren't flush with credit either at the time. And this was definitely a budget rehab. You know, I look at the house, and there's a lot of things I probably would have done differently. In fact, there's a ton of things I would have done differently with the knowledge that I have now. And the tenants, they're very good-hearted. I think they're from El Salvador or Honduras, one of the two. I think it's Honduras. And they work really hard, and they're good tenants, but they have boundary issues when it comes to putting products down or, you know, trying to figure something out with the flooring and things like that, where if they ever move out, and I hope they don't, if they ever move out, it's going to be a lot of work to get this thing back in order. But that's the nature of the business. It's okay. You know, I hope the kitchen cabinets somewhat survive. They were used anyways. I'm not 100% sure. But just something to keep in mind is, don't go with the cheapest solution. I understand that money is a constraint. Time is a constraint too. And, you know, you might be able to get something for like $60 versus, you know, the $98 I just paid and swapped out. And honestly, the installation was so easy. I think it might have taken 8 minutes tops. Most of that was pulling out the old stuff, but it should last a long time. My time is worth money now, a lot more now than it was when I first rehabbed this home. I had a lack of money, and obviously the only other currency you have to trade in is time. And, you know, these are just lessons that I've learned. I think from now on, we'll always go with a Moen product. They're easy to deal with. They work, they look good, and you know, you don't have to go with the expensive one. I think we went with one of the bottom end ones. You know, you don't need to spend $215 or whatever it is, unless it's like an A-class property. Spend the extra money, and don't be afraid to look for used ones on Craigslist, Facebook Marketplace, Nextdoor.com, etc., etc. I have no problem buying that if I can get a good deal. Just to let you know, look up kitchen sinks. Oftentimes they'll have a good faucet attached to it. But anyways, you know, the time that I had to waste going to Home Depot, purchasing a new faucet, sat there. Some lady actually asked me for some help on some garbage disposals. You know, I was glad I was able to help her out. and give her my opinion, by no means an expert, you know, had to travel in traffic, get there, had to wait a little while for someone to come home, scared the crap out of me because I wasn't expecting anybody home. And then obviously, you know, getting underneath the sink and, you know, cleaning it up and just getting everything replaced. However, in the end of the day, the client or the resident, the tenant, very, very happy. And going from a standard crappy faucet to something that actually looks nice, has a pull-out handle, you know, it's obviously going to be, they're going to be much, much appreciative of it. And the fact that they probably don't know this, but it's a Moen and it should be mostly hassle-free, hopefully for the entire of their tenancy. Anyways, these are my thoughts on using cheap appliances and cheap faucets and stuff like that. They just don't keep, they're just prone to too many problems. And, you know, the last thing you want is they can't get hot water or they don't get enough hot water on one side of a faucet. And, you know, it just looks bad upon you and they're unhappy. If you fix it quickly, you know, no harm, no foul. I think the bathroom took me, gosh, it could have been 9 or 10 months. So just because it wasn't on my list and we don't have a good system for repairs right now, something I'll work on. However, so what are your comments? Leave them in the comments section below. Let me know, do you cheap out on your appliances and your buy and holds, or have you had any problems with the appliances, like the builder grade stuff that you get? This stuff could have been like builder grade from 70s.